self-flying helicopters and planes are here. It is interesting to know how self-flying helicopters or planes work, and it is clear that the aviation is now moving into this new initiative.
We started Reliable Robotics to create a new type of airline, an airline where instead of having pilots in a cockpit, you have pilots in a control center.
One of the Sikorsky's pilots in a Black Hawk helicopter just transformed a two-piloted cockpit to zero. First autonomous and self-flying helicopter flight innovated at Lockheed Martin. This model, a S-70 Black Hawk aircraft, simply starts its engines, spins up its rotors, and takes off with no one on board. All of this happens automatically. This autonomous Black Hawk comes with an evolution of Alias that represents a leap ahead in autonomous for a range of systems and is used in military and commercial aircraft. This highly flexible system increases the safety of the aircraft and provides the users to imagine how they can use their vehicles on air and future aircrafts for battlefields. It is an ideal fighting companion, which can help the Army officers to execute difficult missions successfully, and it is reliable on the battlefield. This technology is not just restricted to Black Hawk and is cooperating in other aircrafts also.
We're definitely going to see autonomous aircraft well before autonomous driving at scale. Driving has a huge number of technical challenges as well as regulatory challenges, whereas with aviation, it's a much more tractable technical problem, and you have a regulatory environment that is ready to go.
The difference between autonomous aircraft and self-flying planes? Autonomous aircraft is an aircraft which flies under the control of automatic systems and needs no intervention from a human pilot. These kinds of aircraft follow the flight plan until it changes. The flying planes require two experienced and well-trained pilots. Modern autopilot systems are specially designed to execute inputs that are received from the one who is indicating the flight or the pilot. The autopilot has to keep that plane on a pre-planned path, which can even have to pass through climbs, descents, and turns. Fully autonomous self-flying planes aid on top of autonomous aircraft with artificial intelligence or AI systems that continuously perceive risky situations, plan a safe path of motion, and execute those motions. Also, a built-in software that gives them access to remotely operate the plane from the ground if anything goes wrong.
There's no joystick. You're not remotely sticking the plane. With our system, we give the remote pilot essentially an interface that lets them specify all of this information, load it all into the system, and then press execute. And then that is then transferred through a SATCOM link up to the aircraft.
These systems will also need to be smart enough to interpret the difference between buildings, birds, and other aircraft in any environment or weather condition. Designing such a system requires a lot of engineering development that includes simulation software and hardware in the loop testing. The advantage to fully autonomous self-flying is that it can recognize anomalous behavior immediately. For example, if there is an engine failure in the aircraft, it will respond through an alarm and operates a pre-programmed emergency response without human hesitation or error, then takes the aircraft in a safe phase. After that, the remote pilot will guide the aircraft to an emergency landing location. Self-flying planes to autonomous aircraft? Not if, but when. Sensors will need a lot of development to make autonomous aircraft a reality. You just can't expect to stick a camera on an aircraft and assume it will be able to see everything in an urban environment. Just like the human eye, cameras would be useless in certain conditions, like fog or glare. Consequently, engineers will need to develop radar cameras, sound, and infrared sensors to perceive the environment. Then combine this information from devices to get an accurate picture of the environment for every flight and weather condition. The perceived information will then need to be communicated to the aircraft software and AI systems to plan out a safe flight. These systems will also need to be developed and tested to ensure functional safety. In other words, engineers need to ensure that the self-flying autonomous aircraft will make the safest decision in every conceivable situation. In the present time, most of the aircrafts have a high level of automatic facility, but pilots still have to work in it. Like on commercial flights, pilots are telling the autopilot what to do. In the future, aircraft will not just be automated. They will be fully autonomous, self-flying, where pilots are not needed within the aircraft. Instead, you have pilots in a control center, especially for freight and short-range flights. We hope you enjoyed the video. Please support us by hitting the like button and share your reviews in your comment. Thanks for watching.